Hi everyone and welcome back. So in my recent couple of videos, what I'm covering is JavaScript problem solving questions. Like you have an anagram, you have a palindrome, you have a string reverse, you have a sentence reverse, word reverse, removing the duplicates, all the very basic set of questions from JavaScript, which you can see here and there, right? Even these are the very basic questions which you might encounter in the interviews, right? So first we are covering the very basics, then we will talk about in depth about stack queue and linked list. We have covered them in the phase one, where we talked about the implementation of stack using classes, using functions, linked list, how to write the linked list, how to insert a node, all those things. Basic questions we have covered. Now we came to a point where, okay, let's also talk about some good set of questions which are popular in JavaScript world, like all those things, anagrams, string reverse, duplicates, finding the max, second max in an array, checking two objects are equals or not, cloning the objects, copying the object, all these basic questions are popular. Okay, in the last video, what we did is we covered about getting the maximum character count, like this is hello world, right? So you can see L is coming three times in this particular string. So the maximum count is 3, and the character which is coming with the maximum count is L, right? So that was the last video we have done. Now what we are going to do is we are going to write another function. Let's say the problem statement is this. We have to check if two strings are anagram or not. So I have one string hello world, okay, and another string is, they are anagram. Anagram means whatever the characters you have in a single string, that should be the same in the another string. Even if there is a duplication exists, right? Like TKS, right? This is anagram to STK. Whatever the order is, but the character exists in both the strings. Even there can be duplications like TTKS, okay? And it is anagram with SK. TTT. Now if you just try to remove one character in this, now they are not anagram, because in the first string T is coming thrice, but in second string T is coming twice, not anagram, right? Okay, so how we can write a code? We can use this code block somewhat, okay, just to get the object. So what this particular code is doing, it is giving us the object. What kind of object? So this count, you can see character count, this can be a function. What this function is giving us, from this string it is giving us an object saying, okay, T is coming only one time, right? K is coming one time. So we will pass two different strings here for this method, and we will get their character counts, individual character counts. Even if there is a duplication, I mean the repetition of characters, that character will come twice or thrice, right? So character count is nothing but it is returning a object, okay? We are iterating onto this using for of loop. And if you wanted to actually replace it, like if you wanted to get a clean string, that also you can do, const clean string equal to, what we can do is string dot replace, okay, and replacement we already know, we are actually removing all non-alphanumeric characters and we are replacing that with the space, and we are also converting it to the lower case. Okay, so we got finally our clean string. We will iterate onto this characters of clean string. Okay, then characters, it is going to give us the map. You can say it is a map. Okay, so what we are doing is map of character equal to map of character of A. So this is how we can create. If initially that character doesn't exist in the object, initialize it with 1, but when there is a repetition of character, just increase the character value with 1. So if character is getting repeated thrice, then t will come with the value 3. Okay, and finally return that object. Okay, so now how we are going to do is we are going to check if the two strings are anagrams or not. Okay, so we are taking two string as input, string 1 comma string 2. Okay, and in this code first we will get the character count object, because this is going to give us object 1 equal to character count for the first string, string 1. Similarly, we can do for the second string, character object 2, and it is string 2. Right, now we got both the objects with key value pairs. Key contains the characters and count contains the number of occurrences of that character. Right, now what we can do is, first basic condition is, if we are checking for anagram, then the number of the length of both the objects should be same. So object dot keys, so this is an object, so using this we can actually get the length, character object 1 dot length should be equal to, or let's check negative condition, if this is not equal to object dot keys, character object 2 dot length, because object dot keys will give you array, and then you can actually check the length. If this is like this, then we will return false, they are not anagram. Okay, rest we just iterate on one object and we'll see if the character count in both the objects are same or not. Right, let character of char object 1 key of character object 1, here we will just check if character object 1 of character, particular character, if that is not equal to character object 2 of character. If this is true, then we will also do a return false, so we are just checking negative condition. If all is well, then return true. Right, so always take care of the negative condition, rest return true. Right, so this is basic anagram code. What it is checking is if two strings are behaving the same or not, and you can also do this check. I can actually call this. Okay, and we can actually call this function console.log anagrams of let's say tks, and this was the problem. We are doing a for of loop, but this is an object. Okay, so this is returning true. Now we can just check for this also. So we should get false for the second ones. You can see we are getting false, true, false, false, right? So this is the first question, checking the string's anagram, and this is the simplest way of doing it. We converted the string into the object map, and then we are just checking the length of both the objects, or iterating on a particular object and checking if the value of a particular character count is same or not, otherwise return false. Okay.